Robert, how many years were you a pro fighter?
I was a pro fighter 9 years. I turned pro at 17, and my last fight was at 26.
And you became a world champ? You only had one or two losses,
I was champion,
right?
At 23. I became champion at 23.
And you only had a very few losses, right?
Three losses.
And you had like, what, 35 wins, 36 wins?
Like 35, I think.
Did you ever have to appeal a decision when you fought?
No.
How about as a coach? Yeah,
I got knocked out all three. How the fuck was I going to appeal on my decisions? The three fights that I lost, I got knocked out. Oh, fuck, I got to appeal because I don't think I was a knockout.
Okay,
I don't think that was a knockout.
But okay.
I think the ref counted too fast.
As a coach, you've had over 50 championship fights, some of them very controversial.
Yeah.
Did you ever think of appealing those?
Nothing you could do. Okay. Marines.
Jackson Marines rolling.
Against Rollies. That one, you could have easily appealed.
Well, why didn't you?
Because I wasn't his manager either.
But if his manager would have appealed it, would it have made a difference?
It should have. Yes, it should have. Plus, if I'm not mistaken, it was the fucking title fight.
Yes, it was a title fight.
A world title fight. And they didn't even test or anything.
No testing.
Yeah. Chepe asked the promoters and the commissioners, what time are we going to test before the fight? Oh, we're not testing.
Where was the fight? Where did it take place?
Huh? I don't even remember.
I'm joking. But
and then after the fight, you know, okay, well, we're ready to test. Oh, no, we're not testing for this fight. The fuck? It's a world title fight.
So, Egas Klimas, the manager, a very successful manager in boxing, he's very serious about fighting this all the way to the end. Tell me, you say he should because Loma got robbed. He should have won.
I think he won.
Okay, so what happens in this process? Do you know how does it work? Like, who do you appeal?
I have no idea, but he has to go to the commission, obviously.
Okay.
And I'm pretty sure they're gonna try to deny it.
Okay.
But if he's pushing for it, he'll get a hearing maybe.
And then they'll say...
And they won't change their decision.
But they'll...
Because I think Marines and versus Rollins was a lot clearer. You know what I mean? But I think they could probably win by getting an immediate rematch.
And what happens in a rematch, Loma and Haney?
Well, we can see the same thing, but now they know each other, so maybe Haney's going to fight different. I don't know.
He said he fought different in this
Who's
fight.
Who's Haney's trainer?
His dad.
Has he been his trainer since those?
No, he's had about 10 different trainers since. Every week it's
so
a new trainer.
From everybody.
Yeah, but it's not consistent. One day it's Mike McCullough. One day it's Big Floyd.
Not that I'm saying he needs to, but it wouldn't be a bad idea to let somebody else take over. It wouldn't be a bad idea to get.
But many times dads in general, I'm not talking about his, many times the dads want to be the guy in the corner for TV, for this. I see it a lot.
Of course. I know that.
And sometimes it works.
But then there's dads that do that.
Like your dad.
That works. You know, but actually, when even when I was a fighter, my dad always had help. You know, when I became champion, my dad had Lou Duva there with us. You know.
How was Lou Duva? I met him at a restaurant once.
Lou Duva had a fucked up ankle when I fought. So I don't know if he's the one that was inside the ring. But when I was up there, we always had Robert Alcazar because I was training with
former Oscar De La Hoya trainer.
Oscar De La Hoya.
Yeah.
So my dad was never one of those that wanted to be the main guy inside the ring or wanted the attention. My dad always knew that if he needs help, he'll get help.
But
then there's those dads that want to be the main ones, but sometimes they do need help.
You recommend Haney to get another coach?
No, I don't recommend him because he's done a great job. His kids are undisputed. But I'm saying, if they have to go to the rematch and they're forced, I think he'll make it and not fire him. But if he does, maybe something new wouldn't be a bad idea.
You think Haney's not going to stay at 35?
If he has to fight Loma, no.
Why?
If he gets a fight with Tank or...
He's not going to fight Tank, Robert. Tank's too dangerous for him.
I'm just saying. If he gets a fight with Tank or Shakur, fucking...
Even Shakur's too dangerous for him.
But a huge payday?
I don't think he fights Shakur.
Maybe that'll convince him to stay. If he has to fight a rematch with Loma or somebody like Raymond, he won't. He'll vacate his titles. I might be wrong. Maybe he can prove me wrong and that'd be nice, man. Because I like him.
He said the way... He's a good kid.
I like him.
But the way...
I'm telling you, I had never really had a conversation with him. And before the wins, he was cool. He was talking to me before the wins. After the wins, he was talking to me really cool.
Oscar,
his dad's always showed me respect, you know.
Nah, listen, it's boxing. You got to respect everybody. You're going to see everybody. You're going to work with everybody. Oscar, the dad told me I need to change my last name.
Why?
He says that
Who's
I... Bill Haney told me I need to change my name to Ellie Davis because I'm too supportive of Tank Davis. First it was Ellie Garcia. Now I need to change my name every week. Davis. Every week I'm going to be Ellie. Hey, Falcao. Should I change my name to Falcao? Ellie Falcao? Because I support you. But Oscar De La Hoya just tweeted moments ago that he watched the fight again and he scored it 8-4 for Loma. And he knows boxing, right? But you can't say Oscar De La Hoya doesn't know boxing.
8-4, 7-5, you know.
Why do all these legends like yourself, like Fernando, like Oscar, all saw Loma win? What is it?
I just thought Loma was... I don't know, man. I was watching the fight there with no noise, and I thought he won, man. Fuck.
So did Max Kellerman, I think. And I don't agree with Max a lot because he was scoring it. And he had Haney up early with three rounds. Then
His score was one they were showing on
78, 76.
I think he had Loma winning by 2 points at the end. So pretty much
Loma turned it around. Yeah. But Loma's a great person, Robert. He's a very professional.
Yes, he
You've never said bad about anybody.
Yes,
doesn't hurt nobody. It's bad for the sport. I'm getting a lot of negative feedback from people mad at boxing. But you can't be mad at boxing.
No, it's not bad for the sport because I just hope they do make a rematch and Haney does fight because I think he owes it to the boxing world. He needs to fight.
If he wants to be on pound for pound, for real,
he
do it.
He needs to fight Loma and beat him clearly. He needs to fight Loma again to be up there and to get the respect. He knows 90+% of the people are saying he lost. He knows it. He thinks he won. I don't blame him either, you know. There's very few people that think he won. But 90-some+% of the world thinks he did not win. So, give him the rematch for the fans. For the people.
There's only one news outlet that's hyping him up. ESPN Ringside, the ESPN internet page.
Oh, yeah?
Every second post, they've been pound for pound. Robert, he's not on my pound for pound list. I can't give it to him.
Not on mine either.
He needs to do more.
Yeah, he can do more.
These belts don't mean a lot when you win it like that. You gotta really win it, Robert. We wanna see fair fights. If you win, you lose, you know?
Yeah.
But
you know, the judges are also not perfect either, man.
Yeah, but they need to fix the sport. I told you. In gymnastics, 11 judges, you're not gonna have robbery. I'm not saying you need 11 in boxing, but maybe 6 or 5 or 7 is a good idea. Imagine 7 judges. That and medical examinations for all judges. I want to make sure their vision is good, their hearing is good. I want to make sure they're not addicted to meth or fentanyl or... We don't know, Robert. That judge could be on some drug. How do you know he's not?
Never know.
So why not check him?
Even sometimes, you know, drugs, people think, oh, coke, crystal meth, or sometimes just on medication also. That's drugs too.
You're
and
right.
That also fucks with you.
Yeah, you're right. You zone out or this,
yeah,
you're
that
right.
Also fucks
I agree.
You.
And plus, I want to make sure, like, they don't have bankruptcy to... Because if you owe everybody a lot of money, it makes you in a bad position to take a bribe. I'm not saying they did, but I'm saying it looks bad. And you have to make sure... I want to see your financial records. Make sure you're good.
That
you have, Robert, you have to clean up this sport. It's bad for the sport.
That is true.
You don't want Louis in there getting... Louis.
Do that?
They should.
Do they know the judges are financially...
I think so. I think some they do.
You're right. Because that's... If you think about it, that's...
Every time there's an NBA referee that gets in trouble,
so
they always have financial trouble.
You think there's also where, because the promoters, I have a lot to do with...
Picking the judges.
Yeah.
I think so. I think they need to get out of the promoter. And I think commissions, they need to stop giving Dave Moretti three opportunities in a row.
How about the casinos and all that? Because everybody had...
Yeah. Everyone was... Loma was a 5-1 underdog. Yeah.
And winning. So that means that... If Loma would have won...
Casino would have lost a lot of money. Yep. That's true. Because if you bet the draw...
Towards the end of the week, to the day of the fight, I think a lot of people, including me, especially after the weigh-in, a lot of people were switching to Loma. A lot of people were switching to Loma. When he said, oh, he's a dirty fighter... That kind of trying to excuse yourself, try to get some help from the ref. You know, that seemed like that was going on. And then what happened at the weigh-in, that was kind of a little bit of maybe being a little too nervous. I don't want to say he's a coward because
he's a fighter.
That's not
the
word for a fighter.
But he was nervous.
Maybe being nervous. So I know, because I was in Vegas, everybody...
Casino would have been in trouble because to pay people...
Now we think Loma. So everybody started putting money on Loma.
I know guys that bet $40,000 on Loma. You know what they would have? They would have made like $220,000, like that one guy.
But I also know a friend that put like $80,000 on Haney, so he would have lost a lot of money.
But so most people bet on Loma.
So he won because a lot he was of money. So he won too. You know, because... So
what did he win back on that? Very little.
Like 30 maybe?
Oh, that's still a lot.
Yes, that's still a lot of fucking money in one night.
What's the most you ever bet?
I never bet money.
I don't bet either. What's the most you ever bet?
Me? What did I bet? I think I bet like $1,500 on Louis.
Did you win?
No, I lost.
Did you? What's the most you ever bet?
No.
Who's the most degenerate gambler in this room? Like, who needs
to... Yeah, Payo.
Where's he at?
Payo's probably addicted to that shit, and that's not...
He needs alcoholic... Even, what is an alcoholic anonymous? Gambling anymore. Anonymous.
He fucking gambles a lot.
That's not good.
He made some money on Raymond's fight.
Oh, that's good. No, he's made money in the past, too.
Yeah, no, because he had Raymond under six.